Hello friends, in this tutorial I'm going to discuss with you the most important topic of the Java language, the data types. So let's get started. So first of all, let us understand what is the meaning of the variable. The variables are nothing but the reserve memory locations to store the values. Okay, whenever we use any data type, we declare a type of the variable of that particular type and data type. Okay, it simply means that we are reserving the memory location in the memory locations, and we will store the particular value, or we can say we will store a particular literal at that position. Okay, for example, we have declared a variable int a. So the a has, we have declared 4 bytes for a, so that a can store 4 bytes at its place. Okay, so variables are nothing but the reserve memory location to store any particular value. Okay, secondly, the data type of a value is an attribute that tells what kind of data can be stored. For example, if we want to store a character in a particular variable, then we must declare a type of char. If we want to store a particular we can say fractional value, then we can say it that we have to declare a type of float. And we want to store a string, then we must declare a type of string. Data type usually tell that what kind of value can be stored inside a variable. Okay, based on a data type of a variable, the operating system allocation decide what can be stored in the reserve memory. Okay, so finally, if I summarize, that variable is nothing but the reserve memory location, and if we have declared any variable, it means we have declared a memory space, and that in that memory space we are going to store any literal. Okay, and if the data type is considered, then the data type is nothing but it is a type of the data which is going to be stored inside any variable. Okay, and if we declare any type of variable, then the operating system allocates its memory and decides what type of the data is going to be stored on that particular variable. Okay, this is all about the variables, and now we are going to discuss Java is a strongly typed language. Okay, it is a very important thing that you must always keep in your mind, that Java is a strongly typed language. What does mean? It has two meanings. First, every variable has a type, or every expression has a type, and all every type is strictly defined. Okay, you cannot store any integer inside the float, or any float inside the integer. Okay, this type of assignment are not defined inside the Java. Okay, all assignment, whether explicit via parameter in method, are checked of what type compatibility. Okay, so Java is strongly typed because everything is strictly defined, and secondly, all assignments are checked for their type compatibility. Okay, so you cannot do any type of the automatic coercion or conversion of the conflicting type, as just as in C, we can, if we used to transfer any float number to the integer, then all the places or the dates after the decimal are eliminated. But it is not in the case of the Java. It will show an error, or it will give you an exceptional ridiculous results. Okay, so our data types are considered, then data types are of two types. First one is primitive and second one is non-primitive data types. Okay, so let us consider the primitive data type first. There are 8 types of the primitive data types which are defined inside the Java: byte, short, int, long, char, float, double, and boolean. But if we want to divide in them into the broader categories, then there are four types of data types. First one is integer, second one is floating point number, third one is character, and fourth one is boolean. Okay, so first one is integer. We will learn about the integer. Java defines four types of integer: byte, short, int, and long, and they are always signed with positive and negative numbers. Okay, the concept of unsigned number is not defined inside the Java, as Java developers think it to be the most unusual thing that they will define unsigned integer. Okay, so we cannot define unsigned inside the Java. We can define only signed inside the Java. Okay, and the range of the long and short are given here. You can see that the long is very huge, after that int, and short is very much less used. And as far as byte is considered, byte is used for very small type of data. Okay, byte, the smallest integer is byte. Okay, this is the 8 byte type, has range from 128 to 127. Okay, so byte variable are declared, use keyword byte as shown here. Okay, now if short is considered, then the short is 16 bit type, has a range of -32768 to 32767, and it is the least used Java data type. Okay, so if we want to declare any data type of short as, we can declare this. Okay, nextly int, the most commonly used data type int. Okay, you might think that if we use a short and byte instead of the int, then it will going to help us, and it will help us to can say efficient, more efficient it will be than the using you might think that if we are using the byte or short in the data type, then that will be more efficient than int, but that is not true, because whenever any calculation is going to be carried out, arithmetic calculation is going to be carried out, then all the variables are promoted to int. That is the reason, is that when the byte and short values are used in expression, they are promoted to int and was evaluated. Therefore, it is often best when an integer is needed. Okay, so whenever you try to any calculation or put into the any expression and variable, then you must try to declare it of int type. And if the range of int is seem to be very less, then you can use long. Okay, long is the signed 64 bit type and is used for those occasions where an int is not large enough to hold a desired value. Okay, because the range of the long is quite large as compared to that of integer, so long is used where integer has less range. Okay, now second thing is the floating point types. Now floating point number are the real number in which we have the decimals, and all the transcendental functions like sine and cosine, all the functions will return the floating type values. So there are two type of floating points, first one is double and second one is float. Float has 64 bits and it is 4.9 into 10 raised to the power minus 34 to 1.8 to 10 raised to the power 308, quite large range. So and that of float is 32 bits and 1.4 into 10 raised to the power minus 45 to 1.3.4 into 10 raised to the power 38. This is the range of the floating type. Okay, so if the float is considered, then the float is can give you the 32 bits of storage. Okay, and it is single precision, therefore it is faster to be accessed. So variable of type float are used when you need a fractional component, don't require large degree of precision. Okay, for example, if in any research is going to be carried out, and suppose in defense sector mainly, if you don't require a large degree of precision, then you will use float. Okay, so in double, if you require a very large accuracy, then you must use this double precision. Okay, it is denoted by double and declared in this way. It is a 64 bit floating pointer data type. Okay, all the transcendental functions such as sine, cosine and square root all return the double values. Okay, so we'll get to the next one, character. In Java, character is of 2 byte. The reason behind is that Java uses Unicode, as Java was platform independent, and that must be character found in the all human languages are included inside the Java. Therefore, Java uses the Unicode. Unicode defines all the character which are internationally known in any language. Okay, so Java uses the Unicode, and hence Java required 2 bytes for each and every integer. Thus in Java, carry is a 16 byte type and the range of carry is 0 to 65536. Okay, So if we want to declare a char, we can declare this in this way. Okay, let's get to next. Boolean. Boolean is a data type which can return only two values. First one value is true and second value is false. Okay, so boolean is used to check whether a statement is true or not. Okay, if we all relational operator, for example case a less than b, boolean is also a type required in the conditional expression. Expression, for example, if the condition that we have provided in the if statement we are going to learn in our next lectures. So the condition that we provide in the if statement, if that is true, then only the if statement will be executed, and if the condition provided in the if statement is false, then that if statement will not be executed. Therefore, the boolean is the most important data type, one of the most important data type, and it is defined inside the Java, which can hold two values, true and false. These true and false are not the strings, but these are the values, you can say. Okay, so thanks for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe.